Hey guys, today I'm going to change a head gasket on this mower. Problem with this is, you start mowing, you know, it fires up, runs fantastic and everything, and then it starts smoking. You know, it doesn't usually happen until maybe about 3-5 minutes into using it. Most common is usually the head gasket blows out. So let's get started.
To remove the shroud, there should be 4 3/8 bolts, and also sometimes there will be a 1/4 inch bolt over by the carburetor.
Once you get your shroud off, next step will be to take your carburetor off, then your exhaust. Carburetor bolts are 3/8. Just set that aside like that. Now for the exhaust bolts. Sometimes they're Torx bits, sometimes they're Allen's. Once in a while I come across there'll be a bolt, but this one is a 1/4 inch Allen. If your mower has one of these, remove this bracket. Then you should be able to remove your exhaust pipe. Some mowers, the exhaust pipe is actually welded right to the muffler, so you may have to loosen bolts up down here. Next step, take your spark plug out. Oh yeah. That's nasty. Now you're going to want to take a rag, old t-shirt, whatever, lay it underneath, loosen up your tappet cover. Also a 3/8 bolt. Next step, we'll be loosening these bolts here. These ones happen to be 3/8. Some of them are 1/2 inch. I also want to take the time to remind you, when you pull the head off, your valves and everything will loosen up. And there's little spacers between here that may fall off. Just pay attention to those. And you should have 8 bolts. Now it should be as simple as taking a rubber mallet, just lightly tapping. Your push rods, set them aside. Try to get your old gasket off.
As you can see on the gasket right here, that's where your oil's been going through from this chamber into your piston and burning.
So to get the old gasket off, pull your pins out of here so that they won't be in the way. Get your piston all the way to the front. Put a rag in here so you're not getting gasket pieces inside your engine. And gently scrape at it with a razor blade. Try not to gouge it. It is aluminum after all. Okay, next, I'm going to clean up the piston and anything left over with a wire wheel. This one's brass. And that looks good. And make sure you don't get your rag caught in your drill. So our next step, getting the head cleaned up. Get some of the oils off there. Looks good enough. Now it's time for assembly. Don't forget to put these back in. New head gasket. Install your head. The bolts. Now you're going to want to take a torque wrench, set it to 225 inch-pounds, and start at a crisscross pattern. Now next, put our rods back in. Aluminum rod goes on the bottom for the intake. Our steel rod goes on the top for exhaust. Now earlier I talked about the spacers. They look like little caps. They go back onto here. Turn your flywheel, make sure your valves are moving. Now we're gonna set the valves, make sure your top dead center and your piston. On this engine, the valves are set to 0.003. Both need to be set. Loosen up your set screw, insert your feeler gauge, until you feel resistance, bolt the nut, and tighten up your screw gun. And we're all set. Don't over torque these because they snap. It's not a good day. You install your tappet cover. Now to install the exhaust pipe. Make sure you still have a gasket there. If it's damaged, replace it. Next, we'll hook the carburetor back up. Make sure the seal is good on that. And don't forget this piece if you took one off. Put a new plug in it. Wire. Now we're going to start the shroud.
Success.